We've only been asking for upwards of 5, maybe even 6 weeks. We just want you to be happy. We want to share with you, Joe Stamboni, producer, things that we enjoy, including the 1993 Tarantino-written, Tony Scott-directed True Romance.
Yes.
And you finally sat down and watched it. It currently sits at 93% fresh tomato meter, 93% audience score. Christian Slater, Patricia Arquette.
Where and when did you watch? Obviously yesterday.
Yesterday.
Time?
About 6 o'clock.
Okay.
Watched it like 6 to 8.
Living room?
Yep.
Alone? Girlfriend?
Girlfriend.
Oh, no.
She had never seen it either.
How is she with watching?
Awful.
Oh, God, Joe. Awful.
Why is she bad at it?
You blew it. Too much chatting and too many
questions. Too many questions.
What's that? Who's that? Oh, what are they doing?
I don't understand.
Why are they doing
How come
that?
And
you go, I don't know. I haven't seen it either.
Shut
I
up
don't
and watch
know.
It. This Just is... watch. Dialogue.
Were you holding hands?
Oh, great question.
maybe for a minute.
Little Where do you sit?
Any making out?
No making out.
Necking, sucking face?
Oh, necking.
Sucking face.
Slight necking, no sucking face.
Okay.
Oh, man. You know when this film came down? Came out in 1993. Box office bomb.
Yeah, no, it was not.
Yeah.
It was.
I do know that.
The film was at box
That's
office
why a lot of people
failure.
Don't know about it, because like you think you got a name like Tarantino and people can rattle off all the movies, but not this one. They're like, well, he didn't really. He just wrote it, but still.
This also came out the same time that Harrison Ford's The Fugitive came out. I think it was like the same weekend. Kind of got swallowed up by that. But
where was your phone?
My phone was on the little living room table.
Away from you?
Yes, away from me. I only had it to take notes.
Oh,
just to take notes.
So.
Oh, you know, a fountain pen can be very helpful.
I think he has a quill with some ink.
The movie kicks off with Clarence going to the movies for his birthday, which he does every year.
Mm-hmm.
And then he, by happenstance, meets a lady.
Yes.
And then from there, they happen to find some drugs. They try to sell the drugs.
Well,
the
before
drugs
we get
belong
there.
To someone. I'm just giving a brief synopsis. Yeah. then, you know, it's the drugs belong to someone and they want their drugs back. And then things get really gnarly.
Yes.
Yeah, when you take drugs from someone who's they're not yours and then you use them or try and sell
case
them.
Full of
that amount
like
of drugs.
A lot of drugs.
Jesus.
Yeah, especially with an angry, racially confused pimp by the name of Drexel, played by Gary Oldman.
That scene is
It's intense.
Okay, go.
It was so good.
You start where you want to start.
Okay, so yes, the movie starts. He's in the movie theater.
All right, is this, are we doing spoiler alert?
Yes, spoiler alert.
Came out in 93, screw you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Starts out, he's in the movie theater trying to figure out what's going on. So I see the girl come in, Alabama.
Yeah, Alabama.
Gorgeous. I have a new crush on Patricia Arquette now. Yeah. She is stunning. And that was the first thing my girlfriend said, too. She's like,
I don't like this girl.
At that moment, I dismiss her from the room.
Yeah,
why?
I say, you head into your bed.
Jealousy.
Because she knew I thought she was hot. So one thing about that scene when they're in the movie theater, I love this. Getting pie after the movie to discuss the movie.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's so old school, but it makes perfect sense. I love it. I love it. I want to do that. That was the first thing I noticed that I thought was unique and pretty cool. Then after the pie, more pie. The quickest sex scene.
Yeah,
I've ever gotten into, and they don't make sex scenes like that anymore. That was early '90s, passionate, dim lighting, just weird shots, maybe a breast here, a butt cheek here, and it just went on and on and on.
And then after the sex scene is one of my favorite scenes in the movie, where she's sitting outside underneath the billboard crying, and he goes, "Why are you crying? Did I do something wrong?" And then she, what she says is she comes clean. She says, Alabama, come clean. And if he tells him to go back to Drexel and after yourself, then you go back to Drexel. Like that scene.
Right. Yeah.
And that's when this music kicks in. Too.
I'm trying to
and
come clean. I've been a call girl for 4 days.
Exactly.
And you're my
customer. You're my third customer.
And I want you to know that I'm not damaged goods. I'm not what they call Florida white trash. I'm a good person when it comes to relationships. I'm 100%
monogamous.
100% monogamous. Listen to the DVD commentary if you can find it on YouTube. And I'm not sure I agree with this technique.
Oof.
Tony Scott, do you know how he got that performance out of her? And he would get in quite a bit of trouble these days. Tony Scott would slap Patricia Arquette. I mean, he'd pop her, and she would agree to it, this method acting. That's how he got her upset.
To get her, like, upset
and
flustered.
Yeah, he upset her, and then the minute she's like, action, and she would deliver that line. I mean, it
but the did the music not kick in at the exact right time in that scene? It like, oh, it's perfect.
And the music, it threw me off though. I was like, what is this like Caribbean music? They're like in New York. It's winter.
Yeah.
What is the contrast to the Caribbean music?
Detroit.
But then Detroit. I'm sorry. It all makes sense at the end.
Yeah.
At the end. So, you know, we'll get
Damn,
to
he's
we'll get
appreciating
to that.
So far.
Yeah.
What did you think of Gary Oldman's evil pimp character,
Drexel?
Yeah,
then we get to Drexel.
Yeah. Villain.
Yes, Drexel was
horrifying.
Great.
This is a white boy day. Do you think it's white boy day?
Yeah.
White boy day.
Yeah. No, that was great.
Where he just...
And yeah, I don't understand this dude. What's his... The main character. I can't remember his name. I should have written it down. What is it?
Clarence?
Clarence, okay. Yes.
Clarence Worley?
Yeah, Clarence. He just turns into like this roid rage killer out of nowhere. He's like the nicest guy. Then all of a sudden when
his love is threatened, mm-hmm. he goes okay. full feral. You know all what right. it is? That's probably one of the most preeminent examples I've ever seen of nerd rage.
Yeah. And the dude, when he's in the bathroom in the mirror, the guy in the gold suit, was that Val Kilmer?
That's Elvis.
Val Kilmer is Elvis.
Oh, okay.
Remember
I told you
Val Kilmer's got a cameo that you will not recognize because he's never in focus.
Right.
He's a blurry Elvis inspiring him to kill Drexel.
Yeah, it's like okay. his subconscious. Okay.
It's so good.
All right, that makes sense now. That whole scene was great.
The music in that scene as well, that like driving techno. Right. Oh my God.
Yeah, it's like hackers, 90s hacker stuff.
Then he goes to see his dad, Dennis Hopper.
Yep.
Another great scene.
Yeah, and that scene where they're torturing him.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Sicilians are the world heavyweight champions of Lyles. A man, he's got 16 tells a woman.
Pantomimes.
A pantomime. And when Dennis Hopper, the dad, turns his process on him.
Yeah. Can I get one of those just the feelings?
Yeah.
Tells him his monologue, which I will not repeat. And then he goes, now tell me, am I lying? And he shoots
a guy.
You're great, great, great,
great, great.
I'm not going to say it, but probably a few.
I mean, we can go on and on. Goes from there. They end up in California. They're trying to sell the drugs.
Then Gandolfini shows up. He's incredible. Samuel Jackson's in it for 10 minutes.
Yeah. Also, and this is me paying attention to the minutia.
Brad Pitt.
Some of the best split lip makeup I've ever seen on Patricia Arquette.
Uh-huh.
The split lip makeup on her looks so legitimate. Like she got her lip popped.
Yeah.
What do you think of the scene at the end where they're sitting in the middle and then the gangsters are on one side, the cops are on the other side, and then it all just goes to hell? What's the one thing about that scene? It was obviously a visual effect that they used to kind of fill the room a little bit.
What do you think? You know what I was talking about?
The feathers.
Oh, yes.
The feathers.
Yes.
The coke in the blood. The red on white.
Yeah.
In that scene paints a Jackson Pollock of violence.
Yeah, the guy gets shot and he just sits down. There's just... feathers and it looks like snow just falling.
The squibs popping on people.
Mm-hmm.
Overall, now that you've watched it, are you upset?
Did we overhype it?
No, not at all. Yeah. Not at all. I want to watch it again and soak it in a little further because there was a lot going on.
Like a Goodfellas, it's infinitely rewatchable and you can start it at any moment.
Yeah,
that's what I love about a lot of
Chris
Scorsese
Penn is in
stuff.
It. I forgot Chris Penn is the cop.
He plays the cop.
Yeah,
it's one of those films that, much in the same way, one of my favorite movie scenes of all time is the Goodfellas prison dinner scene.
Yep.
I watch probably more than the film itself. I probably watch that scene 10 times a year where Paulie's shaving the garlic with a razor. It melts into the sauce. I always thought he used too many onions, but it was a good recipe. The same thing with True Romance. Pick a spot, start it, it's good.
Yeah.
What'd the missus at the end of it think of it?
She gave it an 8 out of 10.
Dude.
Well, she's wrong. It's a 10.